Good day from the Conn Center for Cardiac Longevity. A gray day in Detroit. Why I'm wearing a gray shirt. We had a couple sunny days. That's all we get here in Michigan. Today's topic, one of my favorite, coronary artery calcium CT scans. How to find out, test not guess, if you have early heart disease and jump on it early. You want strong bones. You want flexible heart arteries. What have we learned? First study, real quick, on the topic I just mentioned. If you have weak bones, you might have calcified heart arteries. There's a very interesting process in the body of calcium in the bloodstream, from collard greens, from vitamins, from other sources, non-dairy and dairy products that you might be eating, where calcium is gonna go. You want it in your bones and your teeth. You do not want it to go into your heart arteries. It turns out there's an inverse relationship. Low amounts in the bone, high amounts in the heart arteries. Why might that be? Well, it has something to do, at least in part, with the level of vitamin K2 in your diet. Perhaps you've heard about vitamin K2. New research shows in animal models, I'll point out in animal models, there is human data called the Rotterdam study, that vitamin K2 inhibits the calcification of arteries. That's what it says here in the title. I've read the whole study, and you might want to eat foods high in vitamin K2. There's none of them. Actually, natto, N-A-T-T-O, in the Japanese world is a fermented soy product that is rich in vitamin K2. I take vitamin K2 proudly every day. It's called megaquinone. It's an amazing source of vitamin K2, actually from natto. It's in a vegetarian capsule. I love that. Why? Because the Rotterdam study says in over 4,000 people, the higher your dietary intake of vitamin K2, the less calcified your arteries are, these are associations, and the lower your risk of heart attack and stroke. Also makes your bones stronger, particularly if you take it with vitamin D or eat a lot of mushrooms rich in vitamin D. K2, sweet. This particular product is at drjoelkahn.com. You need the code word wellness. Number three, do we have to worry about soft plaque, hard plaque? Calcium CT scans identify the hard calcified stuff. Well, it turns out that total calcium score is very effective at predicting the risk of advanced heart disease leading to being in an emergency room with chest pain. It might be that the calcium score is identifying the problem and the place that erupts and causes a unstable lesion is a millimeter down. It doesn't matter. The calcium score says high risk, high risk, high risk. Test, not guess. When the calcium score is zero, these plaques rarely, I didn't say never, rarely ever become a problem. Finally, for the vain of us, the amount of hair whitening and graying is independently associated with coronary artery disease. This is the second study in the last 12 months that if you're prematurely salt, pepper, or gray, it may be a clue of what's called oxidative stress, but your arteries may be graying too with calcium. So this was a study of CT scans in men, the amount of gray hair related to the amount of plaque in the arteries, even after they adjusted for cholesterol, blood sugar, smoking, and blood pressure. So how do you avoid gray hair? Well, some of it's probably genetic, but an antioxidant-rich diet, fruits and vegetables, legumes and nuts and seeds, lots of spices, antioxidant spices like ginger, turmeric, and rosemary would be a great idea. There is an antioxidant called catalase that may also keep the hair dark. I do not know if there's any direct data about it being of use to prevent heart artery disease. So, recap. Test, not guess. CT scan. Find out if you have heart disease. High dietary vitamin K2 from natto, from supplements, being suggested for strong bones and flexible youthful arteries. And don't ignore earlobe creases, don't ignore gray hair, don't ignore erectile dysfunction. Find out if you're getting young at heart by design or old at heart because of life. That's it. We're out. Bye.